Hello and welcome to Made in Lincoln, UK, 2016 June edition. This is a social interactive documentary video magazine reflecting and promoting Lincoln District life and events.
Lisa Mitchell. I'm a photographer and I'm currently exhibiting my imprints exhibition at Sam Scorer Gallery. This is the latest piece that I did. I only produced this about a week and a half ago, 2 weeks ago. This has got lots of different layers on, so it's several different photographs that are composited on top of each other. It's also got more written text in. I'm trying to also put my poems and things into my artwork, so this is a bit of a trial piece for me. These are all new works on this wall, lots of layers. I have a textile background. I studied textiles at De Montfort University in Leicester, so I've always liked colour and I've always liked texture, so these again are several different photographs that are layered on top of each other to create more of a print effect. This one again is a self-portrait, with several images correlated together. It's been quite heavily textured to create a different colour wave. This image at the bottom has three different sort of layers on it. I don't tend to think too deeply about what I put on where. It's just more trial and error, see which works with which. This image here's got four layers on it. Just general photographs of feathers that have been edited in the colour suite and then put on top of a portrait of my face. This one again is a portrait of my face. I tend to create a lot of self-portraiture, makes it more personal to me. This again is a couple of layers, this time using a fish sort of on my face. The colour hasn't been altered on this one. Another self-portrait. I tend to take photographs of just random objects that I see out and about or in the house and then worry about sort of how I'm going to lay them later on after I've correlated sort of a gallery of images together. This is a simple straight image that's been mirrored and then heavily textured. This is the pier at Weston-super-Mare, which we visited sort of last year. This is pretty much a shot as it was taken, apart from it was a colour wave, so it's been transferred into black and white. I do like taking pictures of derelict sort of buildings and places, so this for me was ideal. This is a photograph of a friend's doll, who's she's kindly lent to me. I do have a thing about sort of dolls. I love sort of antique dolls. They have a bit of a Marmite effect because people are often quite scared by them. This has got a simple sepia edit on it and then a grunge edit sort of on the top to give it a little bit more texture. These are some old roses that I just found in an old derelict building. I do like to take pictures in derelict buildings. I love sort of old and decaying things, so these were found in situ and just photographed straight. This picture's quite heavily edited. I do like to take sort of fine art sort of portraits. I like them to tell a bit of a story or to make them more storytale-like. So this is edited to make her look more distressed or serene, whichever your view is of her. This piece here is another surreal fantasy sort of piece. I like the pieces to incorporate all sorts of things really. The mask originally had sort of eyes in it, but it just looked more powerful when they were edited out. Then it's got a few textured layers on the top and a painterly effect. It was really about not feeling as beautiful as you should do, and how society makes you feel ugly these days unless you conform to the realms of magazines. So that was what this one was all about. This is another fine art portrait that's been edited. Most of my works tell a story, even if it's not always very apparent sort of what it is, or even if I don't subconsciously know sort of what it is. This is a girl waiting. This is about a broken sort of romance, which we've all been through. The picture itself has been edited, has only a grunge filter on it and a painterly effect to give it that sort of timeless feel. This doll piece at the top is another very heavily sort of layered image. It's got more wording sort of on it, and I've tried using more print on the top of this. This is just a trial piece, really. It's not been produced that long ago. Dolls are always very scary. I love them myself, but not everybody feels the same way about them. This is a simple black and white portrait that's just been layered, collaged together with other images. The butterflies are across the face as well, which makes the eyes and the lips sort of redder, picks out the detail. There's not too many layers with those, just a couple of layers on those.
The Lincoln Grand Prix is certainly the most colourful event that sweeps through the city streets of Lincoln every spring. Not only is this event attracting ever larger spectators, it also has a national and international reputation throughout the cycling world that this is the race to be in. The race is 102 miles long, consisting of 13 laps around a circuit that takes it in and out of Lincoln numerous times. A popular place for the spectators is a stiff climb up Michael Gate, leading up to Drury Lane and into Castle Square. This is where the cyclists have to really pump the metal and try to maintain their position. Tearing through Castle Square over the bumpy cobbled street and dashing into Balegate. As they come out of Balegate, they pass under the oldest Roman arch in Britain and head along into Newport, then onto Burton Road to do the circuit again.
Costavella, King of the Mountains trophy. Flowers to be presented by Sheila Emerson, and the trophy by the organiser of 50 of these Lincoln Grand Prix, Ian Emerson, the winner. He was in the lead with two laps to go. He nailed it with a lap to go and really nailed it by taking the win. From Madison Genesis, Tom Stewart! Tommy Tyne Shaw is one. The Brian Cossabella Trophy top for the King of the Mountains. Ian Emerson presenting the trophy, and the flowers to be presented by his wife, Sheila Emerson. Now we move over to the event overall. We spoke to him earlier. He was in most of the breaks all day. Riding for NFTO, put your hands together for Ian Bibby! In second place, a rider that knows how to ride this time better than most. Unfortunately, still equal record holder with four wins in the event. Just edged out with about 20 metres to go. Local favourite, put your hands together, from JLT Condor, Russell Downing! Your winner. You've seen him on the podium winning the King of the Mountains competition. The Madison Genesis team had the numerical advantage coming into the finish. They played it well. With 20 metres to go, he was trailing Russ Downing, but threw a great move up the inside to edge him out in the sprint. From Madison Genesis, Tom Stewart!
One of the oldest bells in England, 1371.
My Lord Bishop, members of the council, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, pray be upstanding to receive the right worshipful, the mayor.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Mr. Mayor, Mr. Sheriff, honoured guests. Ask a fitting lady. Yvonne is certainly that, and I am proud to nominate her for the honour of becoming the 810th Mayor of the City of Fleetwood. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Councillor Strangle to second the election of Councillor Bodger as Mayor. Councillor Strangle.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. First, may I congratulate you, Yvonne, on becoming the 810th Mayor of this wonderful city, and wish you and your civic party a happy and successful year. Pleasure that I second Gerald Gladwell as the Mayor's consort for the forthcoming civic year. Thank you.
Now read the declaration of acceptance of the office of the Mayor. You, Yvonne Roger, having been elected to the office of Mayor, hereby declare that you take the said office upon yourself and will duly and faithfully fulfil the duties thereof according to the best of your judgment and ability. Yvonne's now signing the book. So I'm not going to read the mayoral investiture. So by this ring, I invest you with the honour and dignity of the mayoralty of this ancient city, requiring you, by the virtue of the authority thereby committed to you, to maintain diligently and faithfully during your term of office all the rights and privileges of this city and country.
In further confirmation of your authority, I deliver into your hand the staff of office.
Craig, you're standing.
But I've had me talking to you, Bill.
Yeah, you've got it.
Sheriff 2016-17.
call upon Councillor Weaver to second the appointment of Hilary Bulleton as sheriff.
Mr. Mayor, Mr. Sheriff, very distinguished guests, members of the council, ladies and gentlemen. I wanted to introduce Michael Willerton, the sheriff consort for the next year. Michael was educated in Lincoln and Paisley. He gained a higher national certificate in mechanical engineering, as well as a diploma in fuels and fuel technology. He joined the Lincoln Engineering Company, Ruston and Hornsby, in 1958.
You, Hilary Wilton, have been appointed to the office of sheriff. Hereby declare that you take said office upon yourself and will duly and faithfully fulfil the duties thereof according to the best of your judgment and will.
Pray of standing.
that's it. And if I could just get you to look towards me, that's it. That's it, another one this way, please. That's it, looking straight towards the camera.
Hi, I'm Jude of Saxon House. Please forgive the husky voice, I'm at the back end of a cold. Now, some of you may remember that a few months ago, we made a crowdfunding appeal on Kickstarter to have the ridge replaced of Saxon House with a new thatched ridge, and to have the rest of the thatching given some serious TLC. The thatcher assured us it was in good condition, the sides of it for its age. The ridge, of course, had completely disintegrated. But he said the sides were in good condition, but they really needed plumping up and cleaning up and so on, so they'd last a few more years. So, fantastically, and thanks to all the amazing support we had from people, we achieved our target, which meant we did get the dosh. And once that was safely in the bank and we'd started sending presents to people as rewards, we could then book the thatchers to come and do their job. So if I can just explain what they've done. The ridge, as I said, had completely disintegrated. It was a hole all the way down. You could stand inside and see the sun, the moon and the stars, and you could stand outside and worry about the whole lot coming off. So that they have replaced completely. And they've changed materials a little from the first time it was done. Instead of using a reed at the top, they used a straw, long straw, to plump it up underneath and then covered it with sedge, which is this amazing sort of flat leaf to it, very sharp at the edges and very sort of grippy. And that apparently helps to hold it all down very nicely. And it's also, of course, being sedge and growing in water is water resistant and so on, so that's fantastic. They changed the style slightly, so it is actually flatter, the ridge now, to the top, and looks more appropriate to the period, I have to say. And then the sides, they scraped down with big tools, they shoved their arms up into bits that were a bit gappy, pushed new material in, plumped it up, tightened it up, cleaned all the moss off with rakes and so on, and just amazing. We watched the thatch come back to a lovely sort of goldy brown colour again instead of the rather manky appearance it had. And when we approach nearer, you might be able to see it's much fatter and tighter, and will see us through the next, hopefully next 15 years. Well, up at the top, as I say, they've chalked long straw underneath as padding, and then over the top it's sedge, which goes over that way on and holds the whole thing secure, and it's a much flatter material, but it's very waterproof. It's all nicely chocked up and the sedge over the top. It's very nice now and secure.
Take it, look for me, reaching out to shore, shore as river.
Well, there we go. That wraps it up for this edition. Now remember, this is your video platform. If you have any ideas or topics or issues that you feel would be of interest to the people throughout the Lincoln District, then get in touch with me and I'll put it in the big picture.